Dear students, today we shall go ahead with the numerical problems and the last portion of multistage centrifugal pumps and the review of the questions that have occurred in VTU on centrifugal pump. Now, the next problem is to try to go through the previous class where we have given the quick review of the various formulas to be used and how the problems are to be used. Here we are slightly going to a higher level problems where you require the complete know-how of the centrifugal pump working and various datas required for the design and how the various parameters will be found critically in the problems now. Now, in this problem, it is required to deliver 0.048 meter cube of water to a height of 24 meter through a 150 millimeter diameter pipe of 120 meter long by a centrifugal pump. If the overall efficiency of the pump is 75%, coefficient of friction in the pipeline is 0.01, find the power required. This is the general problem that we will get whenever we want to go for the design of any centrifugal pump. These are the general requirements of the customer where you will be knowing what is the discharge, what is the height you want to require, what is the height you want to negotiate, what is the diameter of the pipe you are having at the suction pipe as well as the delivery pipe and of the pump, and what is the length of the pipe you have to take from the suction till the delivery side. And the efficiency of the pump will be known to you. And by knowing the type of pump you are utilizing, by type of the pipe you are utilizing, you will be knowing the value of the friction factor. Under this condition, how to find the power of the pump now. This is the, we can say that it is a general requirement for the field now. Okay, it is a field problem we can say now. So HS plus HD is equal to 24 meter. That's what the head is to be negotiated in this problem now. And DD and DS, that is the diameter of the suction pipe and the diameter of the delivery pipe, is 150 millimeter. The length of the pipe, that is the suction side plus delivery side, is 120 meter. And the efficiency is 75%, F is equal to 0.01 now. So you know the value of Q required, you know the area of the pipe, you can calculate the velocity in the suction pipe and the delivery pipe. And you know the general formula. This is the Darcy V-SPAC formula, 4FL V squared by 2GD. Total HFS plus, that is the friction loss in the pipe. This is the major loss in the pipe. That is the total length is 120 meter. You know the value of F and you know the value of V in the previous step. Therefore, you can get the diameter of the pipe is also known to you. You can get the total loss of head in the pipe itself now. So the actual head that the pipe has to, the pump has to work, comprise of the losses that is there in the pipe, losses in the friction loss in the suction and delivery side, and VD squared by 2G now. That is the VD squared by 2G, the delivery head that is there at the end now. So this 24 meter is the head that is to be negotiated. This is the last, this is HS plus HD, nothing but suction head plus delivery head. This is the head that it has to negotiate. This is the loss that is there now. And this is the final head that is coming out, that is VD squared by 2G, that is 2.7 square, VS by VD is equal to 2.7, that we know it now. So, therefore, this is the head that it has to, actual head, the pump has to be delivered. The actual head, the pump has to deliver. That is the monometric head is nothing but what? Between, at the end of the impeller, from the eye of the centrifugal pump, it is entering into impeller and it is coming out of impeller now. Under this, in this portion, how much of head that is to be taken up by the pump, or how much of head the pump is to deliver. That is the monometric head. That means you have a volute chamber now. You have a volute chamber. From there, the delivery pipe is going now. Here, there is the eye. Here, there is the eye now. The impellers are converting. Impeller is converting the velocity, the total head into kinetic head now. The kinetic head into kinetic head now. So this, what is the pressure head at this point? This is called as the monometric head. That is the, this is the one that is creating the, when the centrifugal force is being delivered here. Now from the eye till the impeller end now, here, up to here, what is this? The pump has delivered. That is called as the monometric head now. That is 36.26 now. So eta naught is equal to WQ mono divided by eta, therefore you can get the shaft power now. So this is 22.76 kilowatt pump is required to be taken now. Okay, so now here in this problem we are not taking the casing loss, that it is being assumed that this loss is not there now. So what is happening inside the pump is being taken at the end of the impeller. What is the head generated is called as the H mono. That is what the pump has to deliver, wherein which you are having the loss in the delivery pipe, loss in the suction pipe, as well as if there is loss in the casing, that should also be taken, but it is not there. This loss we have calculated, what is there in the delivery pipe as well as in the suction pipe is being taken. This is being neglected. The leakage loss is being neglected. So total head that is to be negotiated is nothing but the reserve from the reservoir to the water level in the sump. The water level in the sump, water level in the sump to the reservoir level where the water is being diverted. That is called as HS plus HD now. This is called as HS plus HD, that you know it already now. Plus the losses that is there taking place, this plus this is to be driven from this pump now. That actual head is nothing but the H mono, that we know it already now. So that we have calculated, and that should be equal to 22.76 kilowatt. That means you should select a pump of 22.76 kilowatt while you are designing this system. That is the problem it says now. Now the next problem. A centrifugal pump has a suction lift of 1.8 meter. This is HS is equal to 1.8 meter. And delivery pipe is 14.2 meter above the pump, means above the center of the pump. So this will be equal to HD is equal to, this is HD is equal to 14.2. That is from the center of the pump to the reservoir now. The velocity of water in the delivery pipe is VD, that is nothing but 1.6 meter per second, and the radial flow through the wheel is 2.8, that is VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.8 meter per second now, and the tangent to the vane at the exit makes an angle 120 degree. That means it is the radial vane is the vane is moving like this. This is the horizontal, means this angle is 120 degree. This is the exit of the centrifugal, exit of the vane means. So this should be, this is nothing but phi is equal to 60 degree. That you should know it now. With the direction of the motion, assuming that the water enters radially, that means VW1 is equal to 0. That is radially it is saying. And the neglecting the friction and other loss, that is all the other losses is neglected. Velocity of the wheel at exit. Velocity of wheel at exit means U2 is equal to what? Velocity of the wheel is asking now. Velocity and pressure head at the exit. That is Vd squared by 2g. That is velocity head and pressure head. Pressure head means Pd by W. That is the delivery side. Pd by W or P2 by W we can say. And the direction of the fixed vane. Direction of the fixed vane, the guide vane is to be designed now. So this is HS is equal to 1.8. That's what I told. HS is equal to 1.8. HD is equal to 14.2 and VD is equal to 1.6 meter per second. VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to, that we say, 2.8 meter per second. This is what I had told, 2.8 meter per second. And psi is equal to 60 degree. So these are the things that is being required for you now. So how the problem goes, you know how the outlet triangle will be there for a centrifugal pump. This is a radial flow pump. Therefore, V1 is equal to VF1, VW1 is equal to 0 now. So this V1 is to be understood here now. HS plus HT is equal to what? 1.8 plus 14.2, because HS is given, HT is given now. It is HS is equal to 1.8 is given, HD is equal to 14.2 is given. So HS plus HD is equal to 1.8 plus 14.2, 16 meter. H is equal to, this we know it, the monometric head is equal to, the work done is equal to head, that is VW2 U2 by G now. So VW2 U2 is equal to GH now. So G is 9.81, H is 16 meter. So this is VW2 U2. You call this equation 1. I know VW2 U2 now. From this equation now, tan psi is equal to, as usual, VF2 opposite side divided by this. This is equal to what? This distance is equal to U2 minus VW2. From this, U2 minus VW2 is equal to VF2 by tan psi. Tan psi, you know it's 60 degree. This is equal to 60 degree, you know it. VF1 is equal to VF2. You know it already. That is the one that is already being given in the problem now. VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.8 meter. So, therefore, you can get U2 minus VW is equal to. So, U2 minus VW or U2, that you can get it. So, U2 minus of 1.6, you will get VW2 is equal to. But VW2, U2 is equal to, from the first equation, you are having VW2, U2 is equal to 156.96. So, from as usual, as we did in the previous class, the same thing we are doing. VW2 U2 is equal to 153.6, VW2 is equal to 156.96 divided by U2. Substitute in this equation, VW2 is equal to 153.96, U2 1.6. In the last class also, we have solved the simultaneous equation. Same thing you can solve, U2 square, this will become U2 square minus 1.616. If you cross multiply it, you will get 1.616 U2 minus of 156.96 is equal to 0. That's what you will get it now. Solve for U2. The value of U2, positive value, is 13.36 you will get now. This is what we have asked, the wheel, velocity of the wheel at exit. That is the one that is being asked, that we have got it now. Now, the velocity of the next thing is, the next thing that we require is the value of solving the other thing that we require here is what? So we calculated U2, we require V2 squared by 2G, P2 by W, as well as the B2. So all the things can be obtained by solving the outlet triangle now. So VW2 is equal to, you have got 11.75, because you know it now. So you know VW2. You know VW2 now, and you know VF2, you can get the value of this one. How do you get? VF2 square plus VW2 square is equal to V2 square. Using this, you can get the value of V2 now, because VF2 is equal to, you know it already, VW2 is equal to, this is VW2. I have written first here. This is VW2, this is V2. This is VW2. This is V2 now. V2 is equal to VF2 is equal to, VF2 is equal to 2.8. Why? VF2 is equal to 2.8, because VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.8 meter per second. That is given to you. So just substitute that, you will get the value of V2. That is the absolute velocity at the exit. When once that you got it, you can get the velocity of head at the exit, V2 squared by 2G now. How do you get the pressure head at exit now? P2 by W is equal to total head minus of BD squared by 2G. Total head is 14.2 minus of, that is the delivery, total delivery head minus of HT, that is 7.44, you will get the PD by W, that is 6.76 meter now. So as usual, you can get the value of beta from the velocity triangle. So tan beta is equal to what? Tan beta is equal to VF2 by VW2. Get the value of that one. You can get the value of beta now. So here PD is to be, HD is to be taken, not total H is to be taken. Total H is equal to HS plus HD is it there now. I am considering the P2 exit side, that is PD that is equal to, therefore HD minus of BD squared by 2G is to be taken. You will get the answer of pressure at the exit now. So this is at the pressure at the exit of the pump. That should be known to you now. Okay. So there the problem ends now. Okay. Like this, you have to apply the Bernoulli's equation at respective places and solve the problem. In these problems, what is being solved today now. An impeller of 300 millimeter diameter. It is the next problem now. 300 millimeter diameter and 50 millimeter width. That is D2 and B2. Okay. At the periphery. That is the limit. At the periphery means exit now. Has blades whose tip angle backward 60 degrees. That is psi is equal to 60 degrees from the radius now. The pump delivers 17 meter cube per second. That is Q, you know it now. Q is equal to 17 meter cube per second, you know. Meter cube per minute is there. You can convert it into meter cube per minute to meter cube per second. How do you do it now? 17 divided by 60. That will become meter cube per second. Like that you can find. And meter cube per minute of water. And the impeller rotates at 1000 RPM. That is N is equal to 1000 RPM. You got it now. Okay, assuming that the pump is designed to admit radially, that means VW1 is equal to 0, calculate speed and direction of the water leaves the impeller now. Okay, that is the speed and direction of the water leaves the impeller. That is the U2 you want and the direction of the impeller. That is, you have to get the value of beta. The torque is required now. What is torque? We have already discussed in the derivation. Once again, I will tell you now. Shaft power. Shaft power required means from the electric motor, how much of energy is to be transferred to the impeller. There, the losses are going to happen. Mechanical losses is going to happen now. Therefore, before joining to the impeller, before the transfer of power from the electrical motor shaft to the impeller, the loss that is happening is 5%. You know it. Mechanical efficiency is 95%. That is to be taken now. Lift of the pump. What is the lift HI? That is the ideal lift of the pump is to be calculated now. So how we do it? That we will look into it. These are the things that are given now. So now, the first one is speed and direction of the water leaves the impeller, that is U2 and beta now. So this is as usual what we have done now. Pi D2N by 60, U2 you know it now. This is the first answer that you wanted. This is very easy to get it now. Beta as usual, you can draw the outlet triangle and solve it. So for that you require the value of VF2. Here you know the value of D2 and B2. This is already being given to you. The D2 is given to you, B2 is given to you, Q is also given to you. Q I have converted it, as I told, 17 meter cube per second to the second, meter cube per second I have converted, that is 0.2833, that is Q is equal to pi BD VF, that we know it now. When you are taking at outside, it will become pi B2 D2 VF you will get. You know the value of B2, you know the value of D2. You know the value of VF2 you have calculated, therefore you can get the value. You know the value of Q you have, what you have done now, you can get the value of Q, you know it, you can get the value of VF2 now. Q is known to you now, Q is known to you, therefore Q divided by that you will get Vf2 you got. When once you know the value of Vf2, I can solve the outlet velocity triangle, and get the value of phi now. So as we do it in the previous problem, the same thing is to be done now. Vf2 divided by U2 minus Vw2, first you will get Vw2 now. So Vw2 is equal to 12.24, that you got it now. So V2 is equal to, V2 is equal to Vf2 square plus of Vw2 square, you got it now. So tan psi 60 degree he has given now. Here he has given the value of psi is equal to backward, it is psi is given. Therefore, you solve the outlet triangle, you got the value of V2 now, and you get the value of beta, that is how the direction of fixed blade at the outlet is asked. So get the value of beta. Tan beta is equal to Vf2 divided by Vw2 at V2. That means solving the outlet triangle leads to the requirements, our requirements. So first what we did now, I have taken this triangle, tan psi is equal to U2 minus Vw2 divided by Vf2. So we have got the value of Vw2 we have obtained now, because U2 is obtained in the previous step, that is 15.76 that you obtained now, and Vf2 is equal to 6.01 that you know it now, tan 60 that is the also given now. I can get the value of Vw2, solve this triangle by means of Pythagoras theorem and get the value of V2 now. And the value of beta is solved by solving this triangle now. Tan beta is equal to Vf2 divided by Vw2, get the value of beta now. Okay. Now the next one is the torque exerted. So this we have already discussed in the derivation of the work done now. What is that we have called? Momentum of the water striking the vane tangential direction is equal to rho A V1 into Vw2. Angular momentum is equal to momentum into radius. At the inlet it is equal to 0, that because it is Vw2 is equal to 0. Angular momentum at outlet is equal to what? Rho A V1 into Vw2 into R2. This is the momentum. That is Vw2 is the horizontal component of the velocity of the wheel at the exit. Horizontal component of V2 at the exit into rho A V1 will give you the momentum. So rho A V1 into Vw2, that we have got it equal to the momentum now. So momentum, angular momentum means the radius, the outside radius is R2, therefore that will become angular momentum now. Torque is equal to what? Torque is equal to the difference in the angular momentum, the final momentum minus of initial momentum. So final momentum is 0 at the inlet, at the exit it is equal to 1. This is RAV1, R1 into 0. So this is 0 at the entrance it is 0, at the exit it is RAVW2 into R2. Therefore, this will become, this is rho AV1 is equal to WQ by G now. Rho AV1 is equal to WQ by G into VW2 R2 now. VW2 R2. So, this is the torque now. Torque is equal to final angular momentum minus of initial angular momentum. So, this will become rho AV1 into Vw2 into R2, that will become now. So that is nothing but AV1 is equal to Q, rho is equal to W by G. Rho is equal to W by G, that we know it now. And AV1 is equal to Q, you know it now. So WQ by G into Vw2 R2 will give the torque now. So R2 is equal to 0.3 by 2 because outside radius is 0.6 he has given now. So 0.3, you just see it. Outside radius equal to 0.3 he has given now. So that will become 0.3 by 2. That will become the R2 now. So you will get the torque. Like that you have to get the torque now. So now the shaft power is required. Now for in finding the shaft power, impeller rod power is to be found. 2 pi nt divided by 60 will give you the impeller torque. So impeller torque is known to you now, so just obtain it. That is 54.45. this is the impeller torque that is actually developed, but the mechanical efficiency is 95%. Therefore the shaft power will be equal to impeller power divided by shaft power. This is the output from the electric motor shaft to the impeller. Now that is 54.45. this is the shaft power, 95% efficiency is there. So this is the output, this is the output, this is the input, this is the input. Therefore output divided by input will give you the shaft power. That is the actual power that the electric motor has to transfer is 57.31. when it transfer 57.31, actually the energy that will be transferred to the impeller is only 54.45. that you have to understand now. So electric motor is being connected to the pump now. So pump is rotating in this direction now. So this is being transferred, the shaft power is being transferred to the impeller which is rotating. That is 54.45 kilowatts. So shaft power that is to be transferred is 57.31. That you should know it. Now the lift of the pump now. So lift of the impeller power is equal to what you know it. Impeller power is equal to, this is the head that it has to negotiate, WQH actually, WQH. What is Q? Q comprise of the actual discharge that is transferred plus the losses. This is the one that the pump has to transfer now. So this is the manometric head, this is the head that it has to transfer. So WQH is the impeller power. This is the energy that is being transferred in the form of potential energy, what we can say, WQH we can write down. But in this case, this is not being given. We shall neglect it. It will become WQHI only. What is W here? It is nothing but the weight density of water. That is nothing but 9810 now. So HI is nothing but theoretical head minus of the hydraulic losses now. So that is to be taken now. So Q is the leakage water that is being neglected. Therefore, what you will get now? 54.45 is equal to 9.81 into 0.2833. This is what we got the value of Q in this. The value of Q, what we have decided in the first step itself, is 0.2833. That is what it has to transfer. It is being given to you. So therefore, what you will get now? WQ into HI. So HI is equal to 19.59. The impeller can transfer. The impeller is transferring 19.59. But because of the losses, what is that happening now? So the head that it can negotiate is still less. So the pump can actually deliver to 19.59. But because of the losses, actual lift of the pump divided by the ideal lift. This is the ideal lift. Ideal lift is equal to this one. Because the overall efficiency is only 70%. That means another 30% loss is there now. So the actual head that it can transfer, taking the pump efficiency into account, is only 13.7. That is, hydraulic efficiency is equal to actual head divided by ideal head. Therefore, hydraulic efficiency into ideal head will give you the actual lift. That is 13.71 meter. Like that, you should solve this problem now. So slightly different problems are being solved in this class. So try to once again go through the problems, then it will be clear to you now. Now, a centrifugal pump in which water enters radially delivers a height of 165 meter. This is the actual head that it is in negotiating now. The impeller has a diameter of 360 millimeter and 180 millimeter. That is, D1, D2 is equal to 360, B2 is equal to 180 millimeter. And the corresponding dimensions at the outlet, this is B1 and D1, and this is D2 and B2. This is D2 and B2 respectively. Its rotational speed, N is equal to 1200. The blade curves backward by an angle equal to 30 degree, psi is equal to 30 degree, to the tangent to the exit of discharge, Q is equal to 0.0389 meter cube per second. All these things is being asked. Theoretical head developed, manometric efficiency, pressure rise across the impeller, assuming losses equal to 12% of velocity head at exit. Now, pressure rise and loss of head in the volute casing. Just look into here. All these things we are considering in this problem. It is a very typical problem. The vane angle at inlet. Power driving the pump, assuming overall efficiency 70%. What would be the corresponding mechanical efficiency? That is, eta m is equal to what he has asked. So, very typical problem. You should try to solve this problem, but it goes as usual what we do it now. So, as I told, the manometric head is 165 meter, that is, H mono is equal to 165 meter. D1 and B1 are given, and D2 and B2 are given now. N is given, psi is given, Q is given, and eta is given. So these are the requirement that is there, that should be taken now. So this is the general equation, Vw2 U2 by G is equal to H, that you know it, that is the work done, assuming that Vw1 is equal to 0, because it is radial, so we can assume it equal to Vw1 is equal to 0. So it is the general equation, this is the general, this is the formula that is corresponding to this formula. So U2 is equal to pi D2N, you know the value of D2 and N, get the value of U2, and VF2 is equal to Q is equal to pi B2, as we did in the previous problem, pi B2 D2 into VF2. The same thing, you know the value of everything, get the value of VF2 now, you know the value of Q given to you, Q is given to you 0.389 meter cube per second is given to you, therefore you can get the value of Vf2. Solve now this triangle. Next you solve this triangle as usual what we did in the previous problem. Tan psi is equal to u2 minus vw2. You will get an equation in vw2, and h is equal to vw2 u2 by g. So you will get the value of he. Okay, that is 194.3. So manometric equation is equal to what? 165 divided by 193.4. So what is 165? The total head, that is actual head that is being transferred, is 165, and the value that is he is equal to, that is the what I am saying to you, once again the same thing, at the end of the impeller, at the end of the impeller, how much it is, this is the I, from the impeller to this much, how much of head it can deliver, that is 193.4. Here the volute losses, the suction loss, the delivery loss is not is being taken. What is this pump can deliver? How much centrifugal force are this one only from the vane, how much is being delivered, that is 193.4. That is the theoretical head, actual manometric 165, it is running 85.3. That is the manometric efficiency now. So now pressure rise across the impeller now. That is the next thing now. Okay. So what we calculated now, we have solved for the outlet triangle, and we got the Vw2 using that U2 also being obtained, because U2 is equal to 45.24. So then I got the actual head that the vane, the impeller is delivering, that is nothing but Vw2 U2 by G. That is the actual head that is being developed, that you know it now. So theoretical head is actually, this is the theoretical head now, whereas actual head, actually what is happening in the field is only 165 meter it is delivering, therefore the manometric efficiency is equal to 85.3, because 193.4 the pump can deliver, because of the losses we are getting only 165 meter. Okay, that you should know it now. Now pressure rise across the impeller now. So applying energy equation between the inlet and outlet, what you will get now? P1 by W plus V2, V1 squared by 2G plus Z1 plus HE is equal to P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2G plus Z2 plus H, head loss in the impeller. Head loss in the impeller now. Okay. So what is this HE? You have to obtain it now. Okay. So now P1 by W, V1 is equal to Vf, that you know it because of the velocity triangle. This is V1 is equal to velocity triangle, you know it. So you can get V1 squared by 2G in this case now. Okay. V1 squared by 2G, you can get it now. V2 square is equal to from this triangle now. How do you get V2 square now? V2 is equal to Vf2 square plus Vw square. You will get V2. So you got V2 like that now. V2 square, you know it now. So you can get V2 squared by 2G, V1 squared by 2G. Okay. And the loss is, loss in the impeller is 12%, that is being given now. So the pressure rise across the impeller, assuming the loss is 12% of velocity head at the exit, that is being given now. Loss in the impeller is 12%, he has given now. So that is to be taken now. So 12%, 0.12 V2 squared by 2G now. So 10.77 now. Okay. 12% of what he has told. Just 12% of velocity head at exit. Very important. 12% of velocity head at exit. What is velocity head at exit? V2 squared by 2G into 0.12. That is to be taken. Okay. So 0.12 V2 squared by 2G is the head loss in the impeller now. So now P1 minus P2 squared by 2G is equal to 193.4. What is this 193.4? Just look into here now. This is HE, theoretical head. Okay. So this is the theoretical head. Theoretical head. Okay. So P1 squared by 2G plus V1 squared by 2G plus Z1. This is the entrance plus the head loss minus of V2. Minus of V2 means exit. P2 squared by 2G plus V2 squared by 2G plus Z2 plus ZH loss. Okay. So that will give you the pressure rise across the impeller. Pressure rise across the impeller. This is the head generated from the impeller now. So now what you will get now? P1 by W minus of P2 by W. That is from here to here. What is happening now? P1 by minus W, P2 by W is equal to 193.4, 3.648 minus of 1761.77. Just look into here now. What is 1761.67? That is V2 squared. V2 squared by 2G. This is 3.648 plus V1 squared by 2G. So what you will get now, this is the equation I am writing now. P1 by W minus P2 by W across the impeller is equal to total head minus of the velocity plus the velocity head generated minus of the H losses. This is V1 squared by 2G is the velocity head in the beginning. V2 squared by 2G is the velocity head at the exit of the impeller now. So this is what it is happening, minus of head loss that is happening now. So now, so this is what V1 square, this is V1 square, this is V2 square, V1 square minus V2 square by 2G. 2G is there now, 2G. This is head loss. Minus of 10.77, this is the, this one, this is 93.02. Okay, so 93.02. So how much of head is increased impeller, in the impeller? The impeller head is raised only by 93.02 meter. Pressure rise in the impeller now. So what is the total head rise in the casing now? What is the head? Total head rise. Total head that is negotiated is 165. 165 minus of 93.02. The pressure converted from here to here now. So I have applied the Bernoulli's theorem between this point and this point. This point and this point. These are the two points I have applied. This I call it as 1 and 2. So at the beginning, at the end now. At the beginning, at the end. So this is what P1 and V1 represents at the end of the, at the beginning of the impeller. P2 and V2 represents the at the end of the impeller, at the end of the impeller, and the losses that has happened in the impeller only. This is the loss that has happened while it is transferring from this point to this point is head loss in the impeller. Okay. So what is this I am applying here? P1 by W plus V1 squared by 2G plus Z1. Okay. Plus what is the head that is actually transferred from here to here? That is the HE, total head. This is the total head that is there now, plus what is converted. What are the losses that we want to be? It should be equal to, should be equal to P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2G, should be equal to P2 by W at this point plus V2 squared by 2G plus Z2 plus of head loss in the impeller now. Head loss in the impeller, I have calculated. This is the head generated. This is the head generated from the impeller. Total energy that is there. Total energy that is there. Minus of the losses that I considered. Then I will get. This is the head actually converted in the impeller itself. That is 93.02 meters. So what I did, the same thing I have written now. Applying the equations between the inlet and outlet of the impeller, I have to write now. That is better to write here, of the impeller. Then you will get impeller at the end of, at the beginning of the impeller means it is the suction side, plus HE, that will become the, that is actually generated, should be equal to total at the exit now. This is nothing, just like the Bernoulli's equation is to be written, and I will get the pressure difference here now. So should be the loss in head, I know it. That is, this is the total head that it transferred is. What is the head that actually converted in volute chamber? I have already told you, volute chamber is an increasing diameter chamber which converts the pressure, which converts the velocity head into pressure head. So how much it is converted? 165 meter. Total head converted is 165 meter. 93.02 is being converted in the impeller only. The pressure is converted in the impeller only. The pressure is converted in the impeller. Pressure rise has happened 93.02 in the impeller only. The remaining head is converted in the impeller. Just look into here. This is happened in this place. 73.71.98 has happened in the casing. So it is playing a very important role. So that should be known to you now. Okay. H mono, loss of head in the casing. What is the loss of head in the casing? Total head generated is 193.4. That you know it now. Total head generated is 193.4 from the impeller. Total head generated is 193.4 from the impeller. So out of that, the pressure energy is 93.02. Out of that, the pressure energy is 93.02. Remaining on in kinetic energy, that kinetic energy is converted into pressure energy in the volute casing now. So 193.40 is nothing but HE is equal to what you calculate, VW2U2YG. This is nothing but the actual theoretical energy that is being converted, 193.4. But actually that is lifting is 165 only. 193.4, we cannot do it because of the mechanical losses. The loss that has happened here is 10.77. This is the head loss in the impeller. Head loss in the impeller is 10.77. That is the That is what it is happened in the impeller. Now, this is 10.77. So head loss, loss of head in the casing is equal to 17.63. Okay, 17.63, that is the loss of head. So 193.4 theoretically it is converted, 165 is utilized. The loss of head, head loss in the impeller is 10.77. Therefore, head loss, loss of head in the casing is equal to, this is in this casing, how much of head is lost? That is 17.68. Remaining 71.98 is converted. 17.93 is being, it is the loss now. That properly should be understood now. Okay. Now we shall go to the, as usual, we shall go to the remaining problem now. Inlet vane angle theta you want now. So inlet vane angle theta is equal to V of 1 by U1 now. You know the value of U1. You know the value of V of 1. It is given. Because V of 1 is equal to V of 2. Just get the value of theta. Remaining thing are same now. Overall efficiency is equal to WQH mono. That is 165 meter. It is actually delivered. What is the power? That is, this is nothing but shaft power. What is being transferred from the electric motor? That is called as the shaft power now. Electric power. So that is shaft power. That is P. That is you want to know now. So you, that is the relationship. That is the monometric head divided by the shaft power. Actual power divided by shaft power will give you the eta naught. You will get, this is the power required now. What is the mechanical efficiency now? You know the relationship. Eta naught is equal to eta mono into eta volumetric into eta mechanical. Eta volume we have not calculated. Let's assume it as 100% or it is equal to 1. You will get the value of eta mono. Eta naught divided by eta mono will get 82% is the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency. This relationship we have already derived. That is eta naught is equal to eta mono into eta V into eta mechanical. Eta V is nothing but Q divided by Q plus Q. This is the loss is to be taken because the loss is not being given in this problem. Therefore, this is equal to 1 I have taken. So, I got the answer as 82%. Very, very important problem. Okay. So, should be carefully studied this type of problem. So, you just go through again and again and try to understand the problem clearly now. The following data refers to the radial single stage double section pump. Here a little change is being done. Double section. Double section pump means what? You are having a pump. We have already dealt with this. We are having a pump where you are having the water enters from both ends. Water enters from both ends. You are having two type, two sides the water is entering where the high discharge is required. That is what double section we have discussed in the last previous class we have discussed now. So that is the only change. Otherwise, the problem is very much similar to the previous problem. 90 LPS, diameter is 100, diameter of inlet, that is D1 is given now. Diameter of outlet D2 is given now. Head is monometric head, that is actual head, that is speed of the impeller is given now. Width at the inlet, that is B1 is given now. Width at the outlet is given B2. Overall efficiency eta naught is given. Leakage loss small q is given. And the mechanical losses is 1.5 kilowatts now. Contraction factor due to vane thickness, that is KT. Is 0.87 and outlet vane angle is psi is equal to 27 degree he has given. Assuming the water enters the impeller radially, that is VW1 is equal to 0. Find the inlet vane angle, angle at which the water leaves the vane, that is the value of beta is required, value of inlet angle theta is required, speed ratio is required, Ku is required now. Absolute velocity of water leaving the impeller, that is beta is V2, what is the angle beta is required now. monometric efficiency eta naught eta m is required now. The volumetric efficiency, that is eta v, is required now. Mechanical efficiency eta m is required now. Inlet vane angle theta, water leaves the vane beta, and the value of psi is also required in this case now. So these are the things that is being given. Just look into it. Everything is being written. 90 LPS means 0.09. D1 is equal to 100 millimeter, which is 0.1 meter. 290.29 meter. H mono 36 meter. N B1 per side. That is important. 0.025. Total 0.023. This is very important. 0.025. 20 width is 25 millimeter per side is given now. That should be known to you. Where we will use it, we will look into it now. 0.023 total B2. Okay, 60%. So it is a double section pump now. So total quantity of water 0.09. The total loss that has happened 0.0927 now. Q per side, I have told you two sides the water enters. Q per side will be equal to divided by 2 is to be there. This is the change that is to be looked into here. Very important. First, double suction. This has come because of double suction. Peripheral speed, U1 is equal to pi D1 N by 60. No problem, no? So, Kf into pi Df. Kf is given. Everything is given. You can get the value of Q. Q is also given. You can get the value of Vf1 and get the value of theta. Theta is equal to Vf1 by U1, that is 0.74. U1 is equal to 9.16. You have calculated in the previous step, just obtain it. There the inlet velocity triangle is being utilized. The inlet velocity triangle is being solved. Now you go to the outlet velocity triangle now. Q is equal to the angle at which the water leaves beta is U1 now. So 0.023 divided by 2, 0.0115. That should be known to you now. Because it is double section is there now. Per side, it is 0.023. He has given 0.025 per side, 0.023 total it is there now. So double section, one side it is equal to 0.0115 now. So these differences should be properly known to you now. This is a double suction, single stage double suction centrifugal pump. So here width of inlet per side, width of outlet total is being given now. Okay, that should be properly understood how to take now. Okay, so peripheral speed as usual you will get now. No change, nothing much is to be done. The same thing you solve for tan psi, the equation is known to you now. And tan beta, the same equation, beta you got. Speed ratio, you know it now. Ku into root 2 gh is equal to U2. U2 is equal to 26.67. 26.357, you calculated it now. This change is to be understood here now. Very important. U2 is known to you. Then only U2 will change. So KU2 you will get. So absolute velocity, water leaving V2. How do you solve this equation and this and this table? As usual, what you drawn previously, what you have solved in the previous problem, the same thing is true here now. So VW2 is equal to V2 is equal to V2 is equal to VW2 by cos beta. So you get 17.36 now. Monometric efficiency, same thing. Nothing. Same thing. And the volumetric efficiency, QP0 divided by QP0. This is the loss he has given. He himself has given. Immediately you can obtain it now. Q divided by Q plus Q. That you know it now. And the mechanical efficiency is equal to shaft power minus mechanical loss divided by shaft power. That's what I told now. So shaft power is equal to WQH0 divided by eta0. That you know it. QP0 is equal to 0.09. This is the actual thing that is substituted, that has come out now. So you will get the h is equal to this one, 36 meter given now. So you can get, this is the shaft power. So you know the shaft power, and the mechanical losses is 1.5 kilowatts. Okay, therefore you can get the mechanical efficiency. Okay, this is the actual discharge that is being this one 0.09. This is the theoretical discharge that you can see it. QP not represent the theoretical discharge. This loss has happened. This is theoretical discharge is to be taken for finding the shaft power. Okay, theoretical discharge and the theoretical head 36 meter. So you will get the value of eta naught is equal to 0.6. He has given. This is given in the problem. 0.6 is given to you. Just look into here. 0.6 is given to you. Just substitute it. You will get the answer. Okay. So this is one more problem. Very much similar to the this one. But some changes are there. Just look into it. Determine the reading of the vacuum or pressure gauge placed at the inlet of the pump, impeller outlet, in the clearance between the impeller and the outlet, and the pump outlet, or delivery flange 0.24 meter above the center line of the pump. Details are given now. Diameter of the outlet D2 is given. Speed is given now. Velocity of flow VF1 is equal to VF2 he has given now. Vane angle at outlet psi is given now. Suction lift he has given, HS he has given now. Energy losses in the suction pipe, that is nothing but HFS he has given now. Energy loss in the impeller, this is HFI I can say, impeller. Energy loss in the volute casing, I call it as HFC. These are the things that happens now. So under this, so I have told you here, this is the pump, you are having the this one now. So what is the pressure at this point you want to calculate? One he has asked, what is the pressure gauge reading here? What is the pressure gauge reading? He has asked you, what he has asked you is reading of the vacuum or pressure gauge at the inlet of the pump. At the inlet of the pump means at this point. And he has asked you at the impeller outlet, that is in between the impeller outlet, in the clearance between the impeller and outlet. So at this point he has asked. At this point he has asked. Now the next one he has asked you here is pump outlet. That means 0.24 meter above. So 0.24 meter above means at this point he has asked you. Okay. These are the 3 points he has asked you now. So D2 is equal to 0.35. Speed he has given. VF1, VF2, psi. HS is 4.03. That is the loss in the suction pipe is 4.03. Energy loss in the suction pipe is 1 minute. Here, static lift, this is HS. The energy loss he has given it as HFS is equal to 0.88 that he has given. HLI, that is the impeller loss. This is here you are having the loss, that is called as HLI. HLI is equal to 0.70, and HLC, this is the casing. In the casing, HLC is happening now. HLC is equal to 1.26 meter. So what is that reading you want to calculate now? Reading of the vacuum gauge at the inlet. I want at this point now. Okay. PS by W is equal to minus HS minus HFS plus VS squared by 2G. That is the, it is the negative head that will be there now. You know it now. So minus HS minus HFS, this is the HFS that is plus Vs squared by 2g. What is the velocity head that is there now? So 4.03, that is the Hs, 0.88, this is the loss, plus the velocity of flow in the pipe is 2.4 square by 2g, that is 5.2 meter. So this is reading 5.2 meter. 5.2 meter it reads now. This is first answer that you will get now. Now the next thing is reading of the impeller outlet. Now I am going to impeller outlet. What will happen now? Ps by W, that is the suction side, plus Vs squared by 2g, plus this is the impeller energy, that is, this is nothing but He. The impeller, the energy that it creates by the impeller is equal to at the exit P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2g plus the loss that is happening at the impeller now. So what is the loss that has happened at the impeller is to be taken now. What is that I am supplying here now? Ps by W plus Vs squared by 2g plus the energy that is being generated from the impeller. In that, I have to deduct the losses that are going to happen at the outlet. Okay. So if you write these two things, so what I am doing here now, here I am writing the equation between this point and at this point. What is happening here now? This is also generating the power now. The impeller is also generating the power now. This is first power what is generating, and here there is some losses that is going to happen. P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2g minus the losses if you do, plus should be equal to what is the energy that is there plus of the energy generated from the impeller. So that's what I am doing here now. I wrote the equation here now. So U2 is equal to pi D2 n by 60, you know it, 17.59. And I know the value of tan psi, and I will get the value of V2 from this equation. This you know it, these steps you know it from the previous class now, previous problems now. So this is the energy 5.2, what is being generated, what is computed here, 5.2, this is the negative energy created now, that is the vacuum gauge reading, plus of V2 squared by 2g, that is nothing but, that is 2.4 squared by 2g, that you have calculated now. This is the 2.4 that you have already calculated now. And this is nothing but VW2 U2 by this one. VW2 is calculated now. U2 is calculated here now, 30.5. This is the actual energy generated from the centrifugal pump. P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2g. V2 is equal to 13.29. You have calculated. So 13.29 squared by 2g plus 0.7. This is the head loss in the casing is, head loss in the impeller is 0.7. Head loss in the impeller is 0.7 he has given. So what is the power, what is the pressure head? If at all, if you put the pressure gauge here now, what is the pressure that is generated that you can calculate from this expression now. Now I am going further into this now. I want to find at this point now. What is the loss that is happening? The loss is happening in casing. I am supplying the equation between this and this, and I am deducting the casing. Then I will get the third equation now. P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2G is equal to PD by W plus VD squared by 2G plus H plus HLC. What is H here now? H is 0.24 meter above. It is there. 0.24 meter. This is H plus of the loss that is happening in this casing is to be taken. Use that equation. You already obtained P2 by W, V2 squared by 2G, you know, PD by W. VD is nothing but V2. VD squared is nothing but V2 square. H is equal to 0.4. HLC is equal to, he has given in the casing part, this is the casing loss. This is casing loss. This is 0.24 meter above the center line of the pump. This is what it is required. This is above the center line of the pump. It is there now. This 0.24 meter. This is nothing but say just like a datum head. It is nothing but okay with reference to datum head. So you will get PD by W, that is the delivery pipe. Like this, you should solve this problem. Okay. Remaining one or two problems are there now. We will solve it in the next class. We will stop at this stage today. Thank you.